in other news this evening, a busy Labor Day weekend with some very eye-catching and potentially very dangerous high surf up and down the California coast. This is Point Pinos today. Waves anywhere from 6 to 8 feet. We've seen a couple tens today. Throughout the Labor Day weekend, these waves are going to be here. Biggest expected to be on the southerly-facing beaches. And if you're going to the beach, they are very worried. They want you to make sure to take extra precautions. Be on the lookout. We'll have dangerous rip currents. And if you get too close to the water, a rogue wave could take you out. Action News reporter Phil Gomez is live at Twin Lakes Beach in Santa Cruz. State lifeguards there and other rescuers are preparing what they hope won't be a very busy weekend.
Yeah, that's right, Dan. That's what they're hoping for. They're going to be manning these stations like this one here, keeping an eye on all the crowds that are going to be out here during the Labor Day weekend.
Waves are crashing over the 8-foot-high jetty near the Santa Cruz Harbor, sending foamy white water splashing high into the air. It's forced the closure of some choice venues where visitors usually watch the high surf.
Guys, make sure you don't turn your back to the wave.
Lifeguards were out warning the casual beachgoers to take notice of these signs because this set of high swells is deceiving.
It'll look calm to the beachgoer, and like, there's not many waves, and it looks pretty safe. And then 15, 20 minutes, half hour later, there's all these like 6-wave sets that are coming through, and it creates these intense rip currents, and it can easily sweep people out to sea.
The waves are breaking harder than usual this time of year. This group of visitors from San Jose has heard all about the water hazards and doesn't plan on allowing any of their children into the surf.
We had told the kids we could come to the beach and play in the sand today, but only to watch the waves, that they couldn't play in it.
And while the surf might be inviting for some other water sports, these stand-up paddleboarders prefer the calm waters within the Santa Cruz Harbor.
I think I'm actually going to stay here within the harbor. It's actually great practice, as you can see. It's great practice for our stability on stand-up paddling here in the harbor.
The Santa Cruz Harbor wasn't preventing boats from going out to sea, but they were warning boaters about rough conditions.
Our boaters have had the flexibility to go in and out. We can't stop them, but we can advise them. All the launchers that are leaving our launch ramp here today, we're checking their boats, making sure that they have the proper safety equipment.
And I don't know if you can see behind me, but there's just a bunch of birds that are just swarming around. There's a lot of school of anchovies or some sort of small fish out there. And that's probably why we still have Stinky the Whale out here. There was another sighting out here today, I believe, Dan. And I believe that there was one, a viewer who sent in a photo of Stinky along with a mate or a friend or something like that. I don't know if it's a Mrs. Stinky or a baby Stinky or, you know. So it was out here again spotted. I guess it's out here because of all the little fish that are out here that it can feed on.
Yeah, that's a good crow run, we're told. Thank you very much. Appreciate it, Phil, very much. So again, stay back from the rocks. Because of budget cuts as well, lifeguard towers at Natural Bridges and Rio Del Mar are not going to be staffed. Lifeguards will control by pickup, and KSBW weather forecaster Art Jarrett will be along in a few minutes with more on the high surf conditions and the rest of our holiday weekend forecast.